Hello, and welcome to another World of Tanks replay. This time I am in my T62A, one of the tier 10 Russian mediums, and I had this matchup a few days ago. On either team, you have one tier 10, one tier 9, and the rest are tier 8, and a tier 7 scout, or two tier 7 scouts, but anywho. So on my team, there's me and a T54, and then butt ton of T8s, and on the enemy team they have an I7 and a T54. Now when I saw this matchup I was like, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. And I mean, you'll see why I was so happy for this. The only threat really in this game is the I7, so if he doesn't go hill I can have a field day. And I mean, even if he does go hill, I would still be able to play world up. And also, as you may have noticed, I have XVM installed again. I had a crappy, shitty session yesterday where I was trying to take hits for people, only to find out that the person I just saved drove off a cliff and died anyway. So I decided, okay, I need to know who is worth saving and who is not. But I mean, I don't really use it, XVM, that much. And also, now I can enjoy my deep purple color, which is always nice. But yeah, I played this game without XVM installed, but I can see now that it's basically just the same, yeah, team setup, skill-wise. Be aware, I use a simplified color scale. I don't have that many colors. So the green band is quite wide. But anyway, enough of that. Back to the game. It's the same color scale I've used in my previous videos. Yeah, I take a few pot shots at the enemies, but I take a hit from the T-34. So I decide, fuck that. And I spot that the I-7 is down on the banana, so I'm like, okay. Now it's time to just rock. The T-54 is with me over here. Both friendly and enemy. So I go forward, I bounce one shot from the T-54. And now it's just... I keep on the pressure. And he bounces another shot. I pull up. And he's just giving wreck. I'm keeping an eye on the guys on the left. I'm just using auto-aim here because I don't need to aim properly. And now there's a Leve sitting here, and here's the gun depression of the T-62A, it's not so nice. And here I remove a gun from the game, but I take two penning shots from it, and I decide, okay, I'm not properly hold down there. So I fall back. I'm still keeping an eye on the south, also the west. But here we go. Now we're talking. I'll just quickly pause, just to show you what the Leve is seeing. He's seeing that. So yeah, that's never going to happen. If he's lucky, he can hit like this bit here. But that's the only area where he can pin me. Or if he snips my cupola, but I mean, that's not gonna happen. And because he's so close, I don't have to aim. I can just wiggle around. And then the Leve just fired again and missed. And he fired again and bounced. And I pull up, plant one in turn. That was his angled upper plate, so I didn't really pin that. And you guys can see I'm just wiggling. He bounces again. I shoot the ground, because that's how good I am. And now I pull up to take a shot in his side armor. I wiggle around. I tried to hit his lip on the side armor, but he shoots and bounces again. And now we just wreck them. And now it's basically just cleanup duty. And as you can see, I've already done 3.6k damage. And again, I didn't have XVM installed, so I didn't know how much damage I had done. I knew it was a lot. And I knew I just had to keep on going. This is where the 62A is just fantastic. As you will see in a second, I can just pound out damage and damage and damage. So here we have a T-34. Shoot him. Pull out. Plop one into him again. There we go. 3 kills. Die is 3 fired. I decide, okay, now it's time to push up. Keep the tempo going. I get in cover. And then I pull out and I take a hit. I don't know where that pinned. Let's see where it pinned. Yeah, straight into my upper plate. So I was about to go around him, but I decided, nah, you know what, let's just trade, hold down, because as you'll see in a second, he has a weak spot right there. You can overmatch him with anything above 90mm. So that's just me going, yeah, that's a nice turret you have there. And I'm like, okay, come on, IS, just shoot once. There we go, okay, now it's time to go around. I track him, I decide, okay, he's dead. Before I can do anything, reload, and there we go. He was dead before I reload. So now, I'm going after the JP2 and Borsig. Just having a look at all the bounce marks. Have a look at all of the bounce marks on my tank. And there I go in, we have a Borsig. I have 560 health, so I can survive a shot from any... Well, if they roll low, I can survive a shot from them. Here's a Borsig. I shoot him once. Now the JP2 comes out, I angle my hull so I'm pulled down. He misses. I shoot him. I load HG. Now I decide, okay, fuck it. Yeah, the Borsig has given up. He shoots and amorax me, but he rolls low. And there you have it. 6.6k damage. I mean, that is why I was so happy to be top tier in my T62A. Oh, not top tier, but have a matchup like this. I mean, this was not even fair. I mean, this was also an ace tanker badge because of... I just... Wrecked shit up, man. Steel wall as well. I think I got Confederate. I can't remember. High caliber anyway. So yeah, as you can see, this is the power of the T62A when it's hauled down against heavy tanks. They just don't stand a chance. I mean, I like this tank for that. If I had been in the 140, the Loewe would have been able to pin my turret because of overmatch. But because I was in the T62A, he couldn't. Unless he sniped the cupola or hit that little lip of the hull armor. So yeah, just a quick video today, but I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly enjoyed rewatching this, because that was a good game. Great fun. And yeah, thank you for watching. I will most likely have some more videos up as they come in, because now the personal missions have just started today. So maybe something interesting happens while I try to grind for them. But yeah, if you have any comments or questions or anything, just leave them down below. And yeah, and thank you for watching, and either I'll see you on the battlefield or I'll see you for my next video. So again, thank you for watching, and I'll see you the next time. Bye bye.